So it's episode Who Cares of the Bomber Show. I don't care. Nobody cares because it's the playoffs and it's a new season and the Bombers are in the playoffs and it's a Monday night at the Whitney Forum. So far, the teams are tied 2-1. It's with the Nipawin Hawks. The Bombers, very fortunate, playing some great hockey in Nipawin. They steal a game, first game, and then lose it overtime in the second game. But it's going to be a very intense series. But now everything comes back to the Whitney. It's a whole new series again, tied to 1-1 in the Whitney Forum. This is a homer crowd, as we know. And the Bombers have a stellar home record this year. So we're looking for some great hard-hitting SJHL action on Shaw Cable TV. Now, tonight, I'm flying solo as the host here. I got no MLA. I got no Clarence Peterson. I got nobody. It's just me, my mouth, the Flint Flon Junior Bombers, and the fans at this great establishment we call the Whitney Forum. So what you want to do is you want to stick around for a very, very exciting episode of the Bomber Show on Shaw Cable TV, because it's edition one of the Playoff Bomber Show on Shaw Cable TV. Here we are with Mike Reagan, coach and GM of the Flint Flon Junior Bombers, tied at 1-1. Mike, I would think a split in a very tough arena, you got to be happy with that.
Yeah, we're definitely happy. I mean, it's funny because I don't know if maybe it's human nature. You get a little bit selfish in that. We're in a good position, you know, to come home with two, and just didn't happen. I thought we played better Saturday night than we did Friday night, so I think that's a positive. But we got home ice advantage. It's now a best of five instead of a best of seven, and you know, if we can take care of things at home here, then you know, it looks pretty promising.
Some tough luck at the cage on in the second game, though. It seems like you really outshot the Hawks. Like, the shots were 50 something to 30 something. Where did it get away from you there?
I just think that you know, our quality of shots were, you know, we definitely had a lot of shots, but you know, I think Nipawin just capitalized on their opportunities. They got a couple the boys walking out here.
It's good. I love the energy.
They got a couple deflections and stuff like that. And, you know, their overtime winner hits our guy in front and goes off the crossbar and then sits on the goal line. And, you know, just some tough luck, you know, and that. But that's going to happen. You know, we are definitely going to create our own luck here. And, you know, we're happy with the way we played, for sure.
What kind of team are the Hawks? Like, what do they bring to the ice surface that the Bombers really have to contend with? Like, what do they have to contain? What do you think are some areas that maybe you can exploit on that Hawks team?
Well, they work real hard. I mean, and they're physical. You know, I think they've got four lines that just compete hard all night. And, you know, I think that if we just match their intensity, I think, you know, our depth is definitely a strength of ours. And, you know, I think that's where we can win, is with our depth. And, you know, that's been our focus, and so far it's worked out pretty good for us. You know, like I said, I mean, we're one shot away from coming back 2-0, and you know, it's been an exciting series, that's for sure.
So since the trade deadline, January 12th or 10th, I think they picked up Lichtenwald, came back, big kid from the States, and also another big body, Berg out of Melford. He wound up there. Do they bring a new dimension to that team, or do they have an impact on that club?
No question. I mean, you got a guy 6'6" in Lichtenwald that's got a good skill level and can skate. He's, you know, an impact player, kind of like Ankoyak for Humboldt. I mean, very nice pickup for them. And then Carter Berg, you know, on their back end, he brings a big body, 6'4", and, you know, he's physical. He's a tough customer. You know, he's a guy that's been around the league for a while, so he's got that experience and that. So no question that they got better with those additions of those guys. But, you know, so did we. Jason Wark and Andy Blank coming to our lineup, I think that we got better as well. So, you know, I don't know if you call it a saw-off or what, but both teams got better at the deadline.
Now, we saw Carter Berg in Melfort. We were playing hockey down there. And at the time, I'm told, and listening to the radio, I haven't seen the kid play with Nipawin, but apparently he's really picked up his game to a certain degree.
Well, I think that, you know, a change of scenery is always nice for a player. Well, it's not always nice, but it can be. And I think that he was just really excited about going to a contender in Nipawin. But, I mean, if you take a look at what Melfort's doing there, I don't think you can call them not a contender now.
Yeah, true enough. Mike, thanks for taking the time to be on the Bomber Show. I know it's a very exciting time, and you want to get back to your players there. So thanks for being on the show. Looking forward to a long playoff run here, Mike. And I hope hopefully we can do this a few more times and carry on this great tradition of the Bomber Show in the playoffs.
I sure hope so, Lefty.
All right. Thanks, Mike.
Thank you.
Here I am with Michael George, assistant coach of the Flim Flon Junior Bombers. Michael, we've been talking to your counterpart, Mike Reagan, a bit about what happened in Nipawin. My perspective is you got to be happy with the split, but as Michael Reagan said, gee, sometimes you get a little greedy, and the two wins could have been there. Coming home 2-0 would have been a fantastic thing, probably the optimum idea. But unfortunately, or fortunately, depends how you look at the glass half full or empty, you got the split. You played two great games there. Your comments on the series so far?
I think it's been everything that people have expected so far, definitely myself included. Our guys worked hard both nights. They worked hard both nights. You know, we came back in that second game there, and, you know, with 35 seconds left to score to tie it up. And, you know, if things like that happen, I mean, you can't go wrong. And, you know, tonight's new night, and those two games are behind us, and it's 0-0 as far as I'm concerned. And here we go with the Whitney.
So what can we expect from the Bombers tonight? I was asking Mike Reagan about what we can expect from the Hawks. What can we expect from the Bombers tonight? I know you're maybe short a body on the captain. Belaski has some issues, but what are we going to throw at these guys tonight?
Well, I think we're going to be aggressive. You know, it's our home rink, and we're going to try and ride the wave, so to speak, that our, you know, that energy that our fans are going to put out tonight for us. And, you know, keep things simple at the same time. I use the glass and, you know, go hard at them.
Like the old chip-ins and chase the puck.
That's the game of hockey. You know, the simpler you keep it, usually the better off you are.
So what are you going to bring in to fill those big shoes of the captain, of course?
Well, Spencer Maltz in the lineup tonight, so it'll be his first game in the series. He's our assistant captain, or one of our assistant captains, so it's good for him to get in the lineup. And, you know, he's going to add some fresh legs and some jump, and hopefully he'll score us a goal or two.
I've been quoted as saying sometimes in a tight series that some of the what we'll call the lesser knowns who can really make the difference, Cole McKeag and Landon Hebert in the first game. Can you make a comment on those fellas?
Yeah, you know, those guys have been really good. You know, I think Kager's had a couple of probably his best games as a Bomber so far, you know, in this playoffs. And he's definitely been skating hard, and, you know, he's a guy that I expected more out of this year, and maybe he's just stepping it up at the right time for us. But, yeah, it's the unknowns. You know, everybody knows that your stars are stars, and, you know, your top lines usually squash and are both even keel. And, you know, when it comes down to your third and fourth lines, those are the guys that win you series and championships.
Yeah, and I'll just throw out another name that I heard in the radio quite a bit, Hounsell.
Yeah, Brock, you know, he's been there all year for us, though. I mean, he's not an offensive guy, but he's scoring some goals now, and he's been steady for us all year. He's one of our go-tos, and I can't get that kid out there enough, so to speak. So, you know, we're really thankful to have him, and, you know, his qualities on and off the ice are huge.
One more name for you, Penner.
Brett's been awesome. You know, he's a kid I definitely thought from day one was going to be like this. He's gritty, skates well, and, you know, he's been shooting the puck, and they've been going in. And, you know, when that happens, it happens, and good for him. Hopefully he keeps it going.
It's a thing of beauty. And speaking of beauty, hey, thanks for the invite to your wedding. You want me and Susan to sing if we can make it out?
You can just come.
Just come? I can bring my guitar.
The wedding's not going to be that old.
No.
It'll be probably a younger crowd.
All right. Well, you heard it here from Michael George. I can come, but I can't sing. Anyway, thanks, Michael, for being on the Bomber Show Playoff Edition.
Thank you.
Once again.
Thank
good
you.
Luck tonight, by the way.
Thank you.
All right, dude.
Thank you.
Hang in there. You look good tonight.
Bye.
Like your shirt.
You too. Thanks.
Here we are with Dylan Belaski, captain of the Flim Flon Junior Bombers, out of the lineup tonight with an unspecified lower body injury. Dylan, your impressions of the series so far, and what's it like playing at Nipawin? Is that a loud place? Is it tough to play there?
It's been a great series. You know, it's been really physical. It's what we expected. Guys are going out hard, and we need to keep doing that to be successful in this series.
Great to get a split there, but you came so close to come out of there with two wins.
Yeah, we battled back hard there. I think we scored like 20 seconds left, which is good to see. We went to overtime. Unfortunately, we didn't get a good enough bounce there in OT, and they got the game winner. But you know what? We'll come out flying today, and hopefully we'll win.
Well, it seemed like the team was battling back the whole weekend. It came down from a couple goals on the first game. Tied it up, like you say, in very very late in the third period. It must be exciting, this kind of playoff hockey, though.
Oh, yeah. No, it's been a great series. Everybody's going out there hard. Like I said, the leads in this series aren't holding up, so it's almost better to be playing from behind right now. So we'll see what happens out tonight.
Well, the Whitney Forum always brings a bit of a new look for the team because, you know, the fans here are quite, what's the word I want to use, vocal and supportive. And is that going to be the, what they call, the proverbial sixth man on the ice for the Bombers?
Oh, yeah. No, for sure. Like, our first game of this series, the boys are ready to go. Like, it's a very high, intense game. And coming back home tonight, it's going to be the exact same thing. Guys have been waiting for this the whole year, and we'll come out and give her all tonight.
Well, Dylan, we hope to see you back in the lineup as soon as possible. Wish the Bombers the best of luck. Thanks for being on the Bomber Show Playoff Edition, March 11th, 2013. Well, here we are, the Bomber Show Playoff Edition. I got to tell you, I'm very excited. I couldn't imagine if I had Clarence Peterson here right now, we would not be able to contain ourselves, either one of us. He would be jumping up and down like a little girl. I'd be screaming like a little sissy boy. But I got to tell you, there's nothing like playoff hockey at the Whitney Forum and the SJHL, one of the finest junior A leagues in Canada. So if you're out there in TV land and this series is still going, you want to get out there and support your local Flint Flon Junior Bombers, because there's nothing else to do in this town except watch hockey and be in the community choir. And if you're not in that, well, you might as well be here. It's great entertainment. The town needs you. The hockey club needs you, so come on down to the Whitney Forum and enjoy some great, hard-hitting, exciting SJH hockey at the Whitney Forum. And we'll catch you next time on the Bomber Show in this extended playoff run of the Flint Flon Junior Bombers. So later.